Hey guys, this is Doug's Dogs. Anyway, it's not quite New Year's, but it's getting close. I wanted to shoot a video, and before I start this video, everybody needs to understand that I am not a tax professional. So if you have a tax question, you need to address it to your tax professional. What I'm going to actually show y'all is how I file my receipts and keep up with my part of my record keeping. You can also go on Vendors United, and there's actually a free spreadsheet on there that I actually use, and it can be modified any way you want to do it. But what I actually use, or you can do like Ben and use a yellow pad, which, yes, as you can tell, I do use yellow pads to keep up with stuff. As you can tell, that one's almost empty. But anyway, the other thing that I use is I actually use expanded files. This is actually a great big huge one, 26 folders or pockets, and this is a smaller one. They're both expanding files, and all that is when you open it up on the inside, you have little folders. And what I do is I take my receipts, and I have each folder labeled. These labels are actually set up by my tax form, which was a recommendation of my CPA. But you can set it up any way you want to, alphabetically order, or whatever way you want to do it. Each one of these are labeled, and behind each one, there is actually a spreadsheet. If you see that little spreadsheet in there, and behind that spreadsheet are the receipts. And what I do is I print out each page of the spreadsheet, and then I attach the receipts to the back of that sheet in by month or by date. And it just makes it easier, because if you know the category you're looking for, car and trailer expenses or car and truck expenses, then all you have to do is go to that folder and look by date, and you can find it. And it matches the spreadsheet too. The other thing that I do is in the very back of the folder, I have last year's taxes. Let me stand up here. So I have a folder that has last year's taxes in it, and it stays behind that. And I rotate it every year. And then eventually the files actually get filed in that little black file cabinet, which is full of all my tax papers. And that's how I keep up with my tax papers. The other thing that I do is I back everything up. This right here, this little thumb drive, there it is. The little hot dog thumb drive is a backup. And then I have a second backup, which is also another thumb drive, which is a bigger thumb drive that holds like mega gigabytes or whatever. Because computers will crash. And that's why I print it out in paper form. I don't know if there's a requirement to have it in paper form, but I'm old, so I print everything out in paper. It costs me a little bit of money for that printer to run, but, you know, it works. Anyway, which I just bought some new printer ribbons and all that crap to get ready for this year. Anyway, guys, that's how I do it. It may not work for you. You may just want to do like Ben and get a yellow pad and write down everything. The point of this whole video is to keep records. And as we come into January the 1st, which is a great time to start, because it's too late to worry about 2020 when you're running around like a chicken with your head cut off trying to find receipts and print out stuff, because April 15th will pop up and then you'll be going, how am I going to do this? So start now and keep up with your records. I can't tell you what is deductible and what is not deductible. Talk to your tax professional. And anyway, y'all have a good day, and y'all know Doug's Dogs, and we're good.